Gosh, I just want to make this map about the percentage of adults that feel crummy. It's county health rankings data, and I got it from a living atlas. I've given it a projection of Albers Equal Area conic, which is a good choice for a thematic map of the USA. But the problem with Alaska and Hawaii is that they're so far away. Hey, maybe I could just add multiple versions of this map in my layout and just move them, maybe even rotate them. Ah, shoot, they still look terrible. But you may have noticed that this Albers Equal Area is configured for USA contiguous states. So they all look great, but if you pan on up to Alaska, it's so sad. We need an Albers version whose parameters are centered over Alaska, so it looks right. And that means we need to make different maps for Alaska and Hawaii. So how do you make a layout with multiple maps in it? It all revolves around the catalog. So I'll hit the View tab and open up the catalog pane. And in this map group here, I have my map. But Pro is project-based, not map-based. I can add a new map, or I can just duplicate the current map. And I will duplicate my map because it's a time saver. I won't have to add and style my data. And I'll rename this map AK for Alaska. And I'll make another copy and name this one HI for Hawaii. And I'll just open both of these up so I have all three maps, my main map, my Alaska map, and my Hawaii map. So over here in my new Hawaii map, I'll double click its name from the table of contents to open up the properties, and I'll choose coordinate systems. And in this coordinate system search, I'll look for Hawaii. And then I'll navigate to the Albers Equal Area that's been configured for Hawaii. Now, of course, the contiguous 48 states look like they're melting, but that's okay, it's not for them. Here's Hawaii, looking spectacular. And we'll do the exact same thing for Alaska. I'll go to the Alaska map, I'll activate its properties, choose coordinate systems, and I'm going to search for Alaska. And then I'll navigate to the Alaska version of Albers Equal Area. And just as we expect, the 48 states go, whoa, but if we pan over to Alaska, it's looking great. But what happens if, when you're tabbing between all your project's maps, oh no, I accidentally closed it. No problem, it's not really gone. Just go back to your catalog and open up that map again. Good old catalog. Okay, we've made our three component maps. Now it's time to make one layout to rule them all. Time to create a layout. I'll go to the Insert tab and I'm going to choose New Layout. And my map is going to live digitally, so I'll choose a custom page size and give it an aspect ratio that matches my monitor. You can choose whatever dimensions you like, of course. And here we are, an empty layout just waiting to have maps inserted into it. I'll choose the Insert tab, and I'll choose the main map, the big one that's going to fill the background, the contiguous 48 states. And I'll draw in the extent of this map on my layout. Hopefully it snaps to the corners, and here it is. And I'd like to tweak the geographic position, so I'm going to right-click my map frame, activate it, and I'll recenter and zoom a little bit, and then when I have everything positioned the way I like, I'll exit this geographically active view state, and then my position is kind of locked in. And give yourself some patience, because it can take a little bit of getting used to. There's a lot going on here. You can navigate around a layout, you can move map frame elements within a layout, and then you can activate a map frame, tweak its geographic position, and then exit that active state. There's a bunch of moving parts. Here's what I mean. You can drag around and resize these map frames. You can activate a map frame to dig into it and change its geographic position or scale. And you can navigate the layout itself. Right-clicking and dragging zooms you in and out, and clicking the scroll wheel and dragging pans you around. But so far, we've only got that one map in our layout. Let's add the other two. I'll go back to the Insert tab, and I'm going to choose Map Frame. And from this list, I'll select the Alaska map that I've made. And I'll drag a rectangular extent down here in the bottom left corner of my map. Convention tells us that's where we put Alaska, which is weird. Maybe it should be in the top left corner, but whatever. It kind of fits there. I need to adjust its scale, so I'll activate this map frame and zoom out on Alaska, and then exit the map frame activation. And then I'll just drag it away from the edge a little bit, give it some padding. And then I just do the exact same thing for the Hawaii map, making sure to align the bottom of this new map with the bottom of the Alaskan inset. And of course, I need to activate this map frame so I can zoom out and reposition this geographically, and then bump back out of activation. And when you resize a map frame, the map is centered the whole time. So I'll typically burn a couple cycles doing a combination of resizing and then adjusting the map extents and then resizing, you know, that kind of thing. Now, the keen-eyed among you may have noticed that the borders of these insets overlap the main map, and that should rightly drive you insane. If I were making this map, and I do make my maps, I would remove this default border. You can do that by opening the map frame's properties, going to that paint brush, and giving it a border of 0 points. But I get it, maybe you do want that border because it tells the reader this is an inset, not really where Alaska and Hawaii live. So if that's you, here's how to make your insets a little less boxy. I'll select this map frame, and then in the context menu that appears, I'll choose Edit Vertices. And then in this cute little drawing tool that pops up, I'll choose Add Vertices, and I'll drop a point over here, and then I'll add a point where it intersects with my neighboring map frame, and then I'll mark this vertex for smiting. And it's pretty forgiving because I can delete these changes or accept these changes. Now I have a nice non-rectangular inset map with no overlap. I'll show you again, this time with Hawaii. And I like to keep this angle pretty consistent. You could also right-click the map frame to edit the vertices. Oh, also, if you're gonna have these borders, let's make them like a light gray instead of black. But people like us, we're always tweaking things, changing it up. So let's say I change the white outline of states to be a black outline. Will the other two maps automatically change with it? No, they're separate maps. So to keep them in sync, what I like to do is copy any changed layers and replace them in the other maps. Sometimes I'll just replace every layer to play it safe. But that's only if you want the multiple maps to look exactly the same. They don't have to, they're different maps. So far, all of our map frames are rectangles or rectangles that we've changed the shape of. Are there other shapes of map frames? Sure. Instead of a rectangle, I can make my map frame a circle. And actually, they look pretty cool. So I'll just drag a circular shape, and it's empty by default, so I'll tell this map frame to populate itself with one of the maps in my project. And for this cool circular map, I'll activate it and zoom way into, say, the DC area if I wanted to provide more detail of a specific place. Now you may have noticed I didn't create a new map to make this circular detail. I just created a new map frame and pointed it at my existing map of the contiguous 48 states. Which is fine because this detail map didn't require a different projection or different styling. A clone is just fine. But how do we know where this guy, which is map frame 3, actually belongs in regard to the main map? Check this out. With my main map selected, I'm going to insert an extent indicator. And I'll choose map frame 3 to see where it lives. And its geographic extent is dynamically drawn for me, which is cool. Well, let's say you don't love the default styling of that extent indicator. I'll right-click that and choose properties, and now I can dig into its symbol. And I'll go into the structure, I'll duplicate this outline, and I'll make that topmost outline white. And the second outline, I'll make a little bit thicker, and I'll increase its offset so it renders around the outside. And then I'll change its black to semi-transparent black, because that looks snazzy. And that's how you make one of those USA map with Alaska and Hawaii over here kind of things. But what if you wanted to make something different? Say, lots of views of the same map. Here's how to do that. I'll create a new layout, just like before, using the insert menu. I'll choose the same dimensions, the size of my screen. And into this layout, I'll insert one of my maps. And guess what? I have to remember to switch my shape back to rectangle. I'll go to insert, map frame, and I'll just choose that regular old map, the first one I made. And I'll start out by filling the entire layout. And I'd like to make a layout with 4 equal quadrants. So I'll drag this to about the halfway point for width and height. And then I'll do some copy-pasting from the right-click menu. I'm gonna make 4 of these things and position them like so. And for each of these quadrant maps, I'll just zoom in on an area of interest. And I do that using the Activate option for each map frame. And instead of that default black border, I'll give them a white border. And that's it. That's like one way to do that kind of thing.